Now, here is another scene I love about the Five Musketeers. It's a scene in which our hero, Rose Archambault, is holding Oliver Cromwell prisoner with a musket to his head. Let me read this for you. Cromwell didn't look too impressed with the fact that I was holding a musket to his head. "Why, pray tell, would I order my men to stand down?" he asked, still half looking at the guards and the knights. I didn't hear much fighting going on from that direction, so my ploy might have worked. Maybe that was just wishful thinking. I looked down at the musket barrel. "Because otherwise, I'll shoot you." He turned all his attention to me. I've had men point weapons at me before. I faced death every time I went to Ireland or Scotland. The death of myself. The death of my friends and comrades and soldiers and enemies. I've been wounded, been struck down with curses, waded through swamps and blood and the corpses of my enemies. I stand before you now, and God himself has been kind enough to grant me these lands to rule in his name. Why should I fear a woman who's never even killed before? This wasn't going the way I'd hoped. "Because if you die," I said, "then England will lose your leadership. Everything you've worked for will be for nothing." "And why should I fear that you'll kill me?" Cromwell asked. I saw one of his hands resting on the sword at his hip. If he drew that, he could possibly thrust it into me before I could move. I had to be ready to shoot if he made any sudden moves, and my fingers tightened on the trigger. "As long as I'm alive, my soldiers will hold back for fear you'll kill me. If I died, then they would fall upon you with no pity. It's in your best interest to keep me alive at the end of your musket. That means you won't kill me." "I could still maim you," I said, and I hated how much my voice was shaking. "A nice wound to the leg would make you helpless and make the guards even more anxious to get you back. They might even surrender without your approval." Cromwell smiled, but without humour. There was a cold glint to his eyes. His lips curved into an evil, cunning sneer that was more terrifying than any words. It was the type of smile a corpse would make as its lips fell away. Pockmarked, the jaundice in his skin made that comparison a little too apt. "Your musket can only carry one shot. If you wound me, then there's nothing to stop the guards from killing you." Damn, he was right. And my arms were beginning to shake, because this gun was heavy. But I had to keep pointing it, so I did. My eyes went back down to his sword. If I shot him, then I could drop the musket and grab his sword, holding it around his neck if I had to. That would put less strain on my arms. If I shot him in the leg, then I would need to re-aim the gun over a relatively long distance, but I could shoot him in the shoulder without much adjustment. Then he couldn't grab his sword before I could get it. Still, the men in the stables had to be planning something. If I stalled, there was a greater chance that we could make it out of here. "You could let us go," I said. They wanted the element of surprise. They wanted to look natural. That's completely gone now. I don't think they'll make another attempt. "Does it matter?" Cromwell asked. His hand tightened on his sword's hilt. They conspired to kill me. Whether or not they'll do it again, they attempted to do it so once. They must be punished for their actions. And you for yours. I was willing to grant you mercy, but now I see that Isabel was entirely wrong about you. It wasn't just the musketeers, but you also. You desired my death as much as the others, didn't you? "No," I said. "I already know when you'll die." Cromwell looked sceptical. "What do you think you know about God's plan?" "You'll die in 5 years," I said. My arms were shaking now, but I couldn't stop. "September, if I remember correctly. You'll take to your bed from sickness. There'll be fever and delusions and pain in your stomach." Cromwell's eyes widened slightly, then narrowed. "Where did you hear of my illnesses?" "Nobody told me," I said. "I just know what the future holds for you. I also know that when you die, everything you've ever worked for will fall apart. Ireland will become free from England. Britain will lose its colonies in the New World. The monarchy will be restored and remain in power for hundreds of years." I pulled myself up as much as I could, watching his hands shift on his sword's hilt. "Also, your daughter Elizabeth would die a month before you do, from grief at losing her own son." That was what finally set him off. He reached for his sword, and I shot at his shoulder. A moment later, I felt a sharp pain in my leg, but Cromwell's sword was on the ground. Guards rushed towards us, some aiming pistols at me. I grabbed Cromwell and held him in front of me, grabbing the sword and holding it to his neck. The guards stopped and lowered their weapons. Now that I'd bought myself some time, I glanced down at my leg. There was blood on my skirt. That was from the musket ball, I realized. Musket balls were too big to get stuck in the body, so they bounced off whatever they hit. Or something like that. I couldn't remember from my history lessons. In the distance, the knights and the musketeers were fighting their way towards me. It seemed like maybe half of the guards had come toward me, with the other half breaking off to fight. That looked like enough for the others to handle. And some of the guards surrounding me were turning back to fight instead of standing around uselessly. Go, Cromwell ordered, choking on his pain. Given how terrible his shoulder looked, I was surprised he was still talking. I wanted to throw up, but I kept my eyes firmly away. Keep the other prisoners from escaping!